Welcome back to EDU in 90. On this episode, we'll share a number of exciting new updates to Google Docs.
These new features are all part of Google's continuing commitment to the over 90 million G Suite for Education users. So, what's up, Docs? A lot. Today, we'll be talking about a new word count feature, grammar suggestions, and a font design to boost reading fluency and comprehension. Let's take a closer look.
Let's start with word count. If you're working to meet a minimum or maximum word count for an essay assignment, it can sometimes feel like an interruption to stop what you're doing and run a word count from the Tools menu. Well, now there's a new way to help you see your word count in real time as you work. To turn on this feature, go to the Tools menu and select Word Count. Then, in the dialog box, click Display Word Count While Typing, and then OK. The word count will now appear in the lower left-hand corner of your screen for easy reference.
Now let's talk grammar. In an effort to help students reduce mistakes when writing, we're introducing grammar suggestions in Google Docs, which uses artificial intelligence, or AI, to help students improve their writing skills. To enable this feature, go to the Tools menu, select Spelling and Grammar, and then click on Spelling and Grammar Check. Now, you'll automatically see suggestions for grammar fixes in your text. They show up as squiggly blue underlines. Similarly, misspelled words are underlined with a squiggly red line. You can easily choose to accept or ignore the suggestions as you clean up your work, whether students are collaborating on a group project or you're a teacher polishing up a lesson plan.
Now, let's go from the world of grammar to the world of fonts. Google Docs is committed to helping students write better and to read better, too. That's why the Google Fonts team worked with renowned type designer Thomas Jochen to create a new font family called Lexend. It's designed to boost reading fluency and comprehension, and it really works. In a recent focus group with third graders, students showed a nearly 20% improvement in what's called WCPM, meaning words correct per minute, when reading in Lexend versus Times New Roman. To add Lexend to your font library, go to the font menu in the toolbar and select More Fonts. Then search for Lexend and choose which variations you want to add to your saved fonts. You'll then be able to choose Lexend whenever you're working in Google Docs, Sheets, or Slides.
Well, we're getting to the end of this episode, but here's one more tip, because we want to tell you about .new. Just type Docs, Sheets, Slides, Sites, or Forms into your browser bar, followed by .new to instantly create a new document of that type.
Hey, thanks, Morgan. I think it's going to save me a lot of time. And thank you for joining us for this episode. We'll be back next week to wrap up Season 5 of EDU 90. And in the meantime, let us know in the comments below what other Google Docs features you'd like to see.
And as always, be sure to subscribe to the Google for Education YouTube channel to keep up on all of the latest news. Check out our last episode to learn about the resources available for educators to engage with parents and guardians.